Hello, promising traders. Alex here from promisingtrader.com with a new DigiByte kind of daily update. I'm sorry, between Saturdays and Mondays, I really do struggle doing these videos. I really have no time. So I just go for one, which is Bitcoin. But from today until Friday, I'm going to give you my update on DigiByte as much as I can, because as I was explained, this is not the day it's been launched on Bitfinex, the 2nd of November 2018, but actually it has much more history. But because I'm not a person who believes on any of these, except I do believe on Bitcoin and possibly Ethereum, but Bitcoin I still see it being the best. I believe on that, but I don't check other cryptocurrencies. I don't check ICOs. I don't check all this stuff. I just do mere speculative trading in the exchange. That's what I do. So I didn't know, but however, nonetheless, even if it's not the date is being launched, I don't have prior information, so I don't know where support and resistance is in the past. So all I know is this that I see here, which doesn't look bad. I mean, it looks like it wants to go up, but we still have this. We need to test this. So we're getting there. Let me check on a weekly time frame. So we had this rejection here with this hammer bullish harami as well, but it's more of a hammer than a bullish harami to me, because a bullish harami wouldn't have confirmation, as there is no bullish harami after a downtrend. It is just a hammer. Now, interestingly, this week, so since yesterday, we have also reached 34 weeks of history in this chart. So we have the 34 EMA, which seems like to be already providing support to DigiByte, and in fact looks this also is appearing so far, but we are so many days away from the end of the week, so like another hammer, which is good. So yeah, it looks like DigiByte wants to follow this channel. Now all we need to do is see, once we go in this area here, when the closer it gets to this resistance, let's see whether it drops or breaks this line, because there was a huge rejection even though we reached this in the week, meaning that probably on a daily or on a shorter time frame we will see a bigger candle rather than a shadow, not on the daily. Let's go on the 6 hours, but probably it's never been it's been rejected so badly. It went there. If we go on a minute, probably we will see it. Or maybe not even in the minute, you never know. Well, certainly not in the 3 hours. Let's see, in the hour. In the hour it was there. So it's been just rejected. It actually badly, because it's not, well, in with this kind of volume, it is normal to see windows or gaps between opening and closing the previous and the next candle. So look, this one closed here, but then the next one opened. I don't even know where it is. Where is it? Oh, here, yeah. It opened like here. So there was a huge gap, which created that big, big shadow here. However, because there's not much that I can see with other shorter time frames, I'll stick with the weekly, the daily. So yeah, these are going to be very short analysis. I have not much to say. RSI is looking like it's possibly trending up. We have this resistance at 49, let's say 50, but it's trending up here slightly. MACD doesn't look bad, even though in the weekly we don't have so much to see, but let's do it from here first. We have this, okay? Now, if we check from here, we have a, well, it's possibly even going trending down. How is it possible? Oh no, hold on, let me check it. Oh yeah, that's why it's possible, because it's not trending down. Look, it's not even trending particularly up, but it's still an uptrend. So we may see this one bouncing on the green and slowly getting higher and higher. But what I want to see is what happens if we start reaching this resistance line, because there was a huge rejection and a huge rejection again, but now there is good support in here, and also the other analysis indicators, so RSI, MACD. MACD really cannot say much at the moment because there's just one histogram here, so there's like one line. This is another line, but it's just represented as a histogram. Blue, however, is far from red, so I don't know. I don't see it dropping, but yeah. The previous week there was no volume, which may be a bearish indicator, but let's see. Let's see how things happen in the weekly, and let's see what the daily says. The daily shows a very good support. Very good support, and we are also closing almost constantly above the 55 EMA, which is good, because actually, look at these lines here. Look at the green line, which is the 55 EMA, and look at them. Yes, they have inverted their position, so this one should be always on top on a bullish market. This one should be the second, this is the third, and this is the fourth. They are correctly displaying as a bullish trend. But they crossed each other here. They crossed each other, but still are finding support, except for now, which has exactly appeared now, which is weird because it's on a daily. It should have been there already. Okay, interesting. Except for this one, but with this one we need the whole day. MACD is, you can see it's kind of shaking, you know, it's jagged. It doesn't really go clean on a direction, but if we see globally, it is trending up. It is trending up. It's just trying to bounce and to cross the red, and it bounces down, but this is something that happens with several cryptocurrencies. Which is why I think sometimes it's better maybe not doing only cryptocurrencies and doing Forex, doing, I don't know, any other securities that are more established, but definitely do cryptocurrencies. Yeah, they do have a high potential, very high, but they also have a high potential to make you lose a lot of money, because that's the thing. It's not just high potential for winning, it's a high potential for losing. However, we don't know about this yet. Let's see in the 12-hour. I really don't want to go on shorter time frames because there's, you see, in the 12 hours we already see no activity sometimes. So what we see here, unlike the daily, we have also the 233, which is being a support. And another thing that I never said, but when the EMA is kind of flat like this, it oftentimes could provide support, which seems to be the case right now. But what we don't know is it going to keep supporting or not? According to these indicators, I'm positive. You know, I'm very positive it's going to keep staying on this channel here, which is amazing, which is really good, really very good. If it breaks this, I said I would probably enter a position up to here. How much is it going to be? Yeah, definitely. A 20%+, indeed, I would do. If I see it coming here and it gives me signals, I would definitely buy here and play all this, indeed, and would probably place a stop loss, a profit taking about here, because due to these shadows, you know, it's just maybe it would just happen in a second, and I want to sell in that second. So yeah, but it looks good. It looks really like it's going to follow the channel. Look, also MACD seems like it's bouncing on the red line, even though how it's trending down, but it's constantly doing up and down, so it's jacked, so we cannot really rely on it. But it looks good to me. It looks good above all because RSI is going up. It's going up here. Look, this is a beautiful RSI thing. And if we consider it closed more or less at the same high, RSI is not. This is really potentially a signal. I'm positive because of the support provided by the 233, which is probably now not being supported, but it's not being supported either in these two, three candles. But globally speaking, it's closing constantly, or often it's closing above the 233, and often it's closing also above the 55, which means this is just temporary thing. It's going to probably be like this for a while, and then it's going to explode, hopefully up. If I go on the 6 hours, I don't think it's, yeah. Nothing is changing. It seems like it's trending down now, but it may very well bounce because RSI is not, it's not very low, it's not very high, it's not very low. My take is, and this is not financial advice, this is not trading advice, you need to think with your own brain. which is why I always recommend the Japanese candlestick charting techniques. I'm not gonna mention it anymore, I'm sorry guys, but because I got this passion, I want you to have the same passion. Because if you're watching these videos, hopefully it's not because you're looking for somebody who tell you what to do, because that is really bad. You don't want somebody to tell you what to do. You need to rely on yourself, on your own skills, which is one of the things that I say. The reason why I like trading as a business model is because it doesn't rely on anything else than what you do, your strategy, even when you lose. Because trust me, I'm probably among the worst traders available that can do technical analysis, because I got just 1 year experience. It's nothing. It's nothing. All the books that I've read, they tell you in the first year what you should aim at is not losing money. It's not making a profit. It's not losing money. That would be good enough, because you need to pile up knowledge and experience. But nonetheless, because I was disciplined, because I applied all the rules that I tell you in the first video, which I'm going to leave you a card here, I was profitable. I made quadruple. Maybe I was just lucky, I don't know, but I quadrupled. Because if you just play by a chance, 50% chance to break this and 50% chance not to, and you place your stop losses and your profit taking wisely, which is what you should do and what hopefully you will understand following me, basically losing less than what you think you're going to win, which is not difficult, because you just need to find the support and resistance areas and place the profit taking here and a stop loss here if it breaks it. That's it, it's as simple as that. You know, if you keep doing it, you, even if you just get it right 50% of the times, which is not the case of good analysts, but even if I did it 50% of the times, I would be profitable, because I made at least 3 times the money that I've lost. So in ten positions, if 5 were wrong and I lost 5%, if in the other 5 I was right and I made 15%, you can tell that 5% that I lost 5 times, so it's 25%, but it doesn't really match with the 65, is it? So 15, 45, 90, no, actually not 65, sorry, it's 105. 105%. So if we take out the 25% loss, I still have a 80% money more than before. You see? So you don't need to rely on people who tell you what to do on the internet, on YouTube, anywhere. So that's what I think is going to happen, but you should do your own due diligence, which I'm trying to teach you the way I can, because I'm just sharing the information that I have. I don't have the experience, I got the theory, which hopefully is correct, but I don't have the experience. So that's what you want to do. You want to take your own books, the one that I recommend. The ones that I recommend are the ones that I have read, which is why I'm telling you to buy them, because I know they work, and with me they did work. And to follow the people that you should. Like, for instance, if you have to go for a candlestick book, don't go for anybody else's than Steve Mizon. Because he's the one who brought them in the Western world. Everybody else, including me, who tells you about candlesticks, is just copying from him. Or from somebody else who copied from him. So candlesticks are Steve Mizon. You don't need to look anyone else. It's Steve Mizon. But yeah, that's the thing. I don't want to look like I'm selling things, so let's go ahead. This is my take on DigiByte. I don't think there's much more that I can look, because if I go on a shorter time frame, there's going to be too much of a mess. And however, if I check RSI in 3 hours, it's still trending up. MACD is not, but it's not even closing below, so it may bounce. It may bounce like it did here. It may bounce on the red and keep going up, which is what I sense is going to happen. I wouldn't play anything yet right now. As I said, I would probably start to be interested if it comes here and starts closing around here, staying here for a while, then yes, I would probably go for a long position, setting my stop loss, maybe just to be safe in this area here. Not now, because we don't know if it drops or not. And actually, if it's here, actually, you see the beauty, if it's here, and I can see or I can sense it's not going to go high, I can go short, I can shorten and set my stop loss around, I don't know, here. But if it drops, I would make a beautiful 40% profit. Because that's the way. You don't need to believe in the coin. You don't need to believe in the coin. You need to take opportunity out of the coin, because what you do, what you want to do, is making money. Otherwise, you wouldn't put money in the coin. Your final goal is to make money. But if you make money waiting for things to happen without reacting, you may lose money. Depend. You can be also lucky and keep winning, but you may lose money. Because we don't know. There are so many coins. There are so many altcoins. I don't think most of them will still be here in 10 years, to be honest. So as long as they are here, you may want to take opportunity and do a short, even if it's against your belief. But if you short it and you make a profit, I think you will be happy anyway. So with this, I conclude my DigiByte technical analysis. I'm sorry if I've been procrastinating the weekend. It's not procrastinating. I really didn't do it because I didn't manage to have the time to do it. But yeah, if you have liked the video, please like, share, and subscribe. If you haven't liked the video and you want to tell me why, I would really appreciate it so that I can improve. Because if you keep leaving me comments saying that I don't know what I'm talking about or things like that, but you don't tell me what I'm doing wrong and what's your point is, why you're saying that, I won't be able to improve. And your comment is really just a little bit of a troll comment. So yeah. Let me know what is wrong with my videos so that we can discuss. I want to improve. I'm not here. I'm not saying I'm the master. Actually, I'm not the master at all. So again, thanks for watching and see you tomorrow with DigiByte. Bye-bye.